Hello my YouTube family, I welcome to all of you on my YouTube channel. I'm your well-wisher, healer and your friend Shazia Khan. Hope you are well and taking care of yourself. So let's start today's video and don't forget to subscribe. Please like and subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get new video updates. I am back in your service with a new and interesting video. So to know the video must watch the video till the end. So let's start today's video. So stay with me till the end of the video. Yes, I am talking about streaming reviews. Dear Bigha Zameen, Pratik Gandhi is the saving grace. Release date and platform of Dear Bigha Zameen. Dear Bigha Zameen, a compelling Hindi drama, features Pratik Gandhi and Durgesh Kumar in the main roles. The film narrative unfolds in a quaint village, offering a unique perspective and rural life scheduled for an OTT release in May 2024. This movie promises to be a captivating watch. Dear Bigha Zameen will be released on 31st May 2024. It will be available to watch on Jio Cinema. Dear Bigha Zameen turns 1.5 brihas of land, bighas of land, in a 2024 Indian Hindi language drama film written and directed by Pulkit and produced by Karma Media and Entertainment. The film features Pratik Gandhi and Kaushal Kumar in the lead roles. The film premiered. The Anil, a 28 years old wheat seller, lives with his wife, mother and sister. Excited for his sister Neha's marriage to Ajay, a soon-to-be civil servant, Anil agrees to a dowry. To find it, he plans to sell his late father's land, only to find it's under relation to MLA Amar Singh. Pratik Gandhi once again proves that he is an actor who can bring any character to life with his dedicated to his craft and instinctive understanding of what the role requires, observed Deep Ghalot. In 1953, Bimal Roy has made his masterpiece Do Bigha Zameen, in which a poor farmer loses his land to a corrupt system that makes it impossible for him to pay back a small loan. The title of Pulkit's new film Dear Bigha Zameen is a reminder of that film and also a sad chronicle of the helplessness of the common citizen today. The feudal system of the 1950s has been replaced by a corrupt political elite that has no respect for the law. Anil Singh, Pratik Gandhi, is a grain merchant in a non-descript town of Ratanpura in UP. He lives in simple life and his wife, Kaushali Kumar, sister Neha, Prasanna Bhisht, mother Nita Mohindra and uncle Dayashankar Pandey. A match comes for Neha and the groom's father arrogantly puts forward a list of demand for cash, jewelry, SUV, wedding expenses. Anil accepts them. For an ordinary man, dowry is a fact of life and there is no escaping it. Having an unmarried young woman in the home is considered shameful in small town India. And there's no judgment for Anil Singh as questions to the odious man's greed. Pulkit, Dear Bigha Zameen resolves around a simple middle-class man named Anil Pratik Gandhi, who sets out to sell his family land to found the dowry for his sister's wedding. But he gets a rude shock when he discovered that it's under litigations. A corrupt MLA Amar Singh has taken possession of his land. Anil goes to the police. No help, no takes the legal route. The case is dismissed. He then decided to meet and reason with the sweet-talking politician himself. Anil knows no bound and is salt of cool that Pratik Gandhi, the actor who turned corruptions into a performative art form in his playing this poor side. While watching Anil run from pillar to post, it's hard not to think of Dibakar Banerjee's Hosta Ka Ghosla 2006. You potentially wait for all the doors to be shut in his face. Anil is running out of options. It is only a matter of time before he rebels. The signs are there: a land dispute, a shady broker, a modest protagonist put in an uncomfortable situations. But it never comes. The long setup never ends. Anil keeps trying. He keeps getting wrong. The tide refuses to turn. The film is so arrow straight and sober that it almost mocks our artistic conditionings. You accept things to happen. Serious, revenge, playful, revenge, comeuppance, justice, beginning and end. All those things the storytelling thrives on. Dear Biga Zameen. Through insisted that life is no film, it's social issues drama, where the message is that most stories can't afford to craft a message. The establishment is so all-consuming that not even a movie can beat it. At some level, it implies that art often sugarcoats the truth in pursuit of entertainment. Anil and his family can't fight back because the system is blatantly rigged against them. They also can't teach anyone a lesson because they don't have the skill or resources to do that. Yet Anil can display beliefs, spurts of spirit and range. He can perhaps find purpose in his fight, but he knows it is going to be a fertile one. In theory, this is a worthy idea. The cast is solid too. Two actors from Panchayat, Faisal Malik and Durgesh Kumar, play sister cogs in the Uttar Pradesh wheel. Anil's sister is played by Parsana Bisht, and promising actor who stood out as a rich brat on the other side of the power divided in last year, Fairy Neeraj Sood, delivers a smooth cameo is a nearly unseen but all pervasive MLA. Pratik Gandhi is on a hot streak, and only he can make Anil sincerely possible and disillusionment in not a dramatic either. When he explored that, like, he's impressed with his own dialogue. The entire point of the film is that it has nothing new to say, fine on newspaper but strange on screen. I like that it riffs on our mainstream perceptions of heroism and social justice. The director's previous film Bhakshak did something similar by refusing to leave us with a feel-good resolutions. The fact is that resolutions are the luxury of fictions, but if the idea is to highlight the helpless of an ordinary film, it's better to explore the morality and stake of the setting. Think Tabbar 2021, a series about a regular Punjabi family slowly paying. The movie is worth watching for Pratik Gandhi's performance and the gritty portrayal of a common man's struggle against corruption and injustice. However, be prepared for an unresolved ending. I hope you all like this video of mine very much. So please like and subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get new video updates. I hope that you are creating progress, prosperity in your works and life. May Allah keep you all successful like this. So now give me permission to say goodbye. I will be back again with a new video, with a new spirit, with a new day, with a new happiness. Take care of yourself. Remember me in your prayers. Have a nice day. Goodbye. Or don't forget to subscribe.